Hey folks, we are at Fort Clinch State Park in Fernandina Beach, Florida. Kind of exploring this old historical fort. Hope you enjoy the tour. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, please consider doing so. If you like the video, make sure to hit that thumbs up. Ring that notification bell if you'd like a notification of future content. Let's go exploring.
the blacksmith and I guess you can call it forge. Metalworks. This rack right here over hanging on the wall is a manual drill press with a big hand wheel on the side to spin the drill.
Old door hardware, isn't that cool? Big skeleton key.
This is the kitchen. Kitchen here on the back, you see the ovens in the back. Under that arch. Access points to wall defensive and offensive positions. Again, this is another corner. We have more cannon mounts here, and it's the same arrangement. This throws down the exterior wall to be able to defend the fort. That's the entryway right there. So this moat that we're looking down is actually looking toward the entry drawbridge to the fort. We're in another ammunition bunker. Can't really see in here. This is another cannon mount looking out directly toward the ocean. Rifle port that's right down the ocean wall. Quartermaster storage, so you've got tools, equipment, paint, all stored in here, all the supplies and materials. Another access point here. You can see these tunnels all over the place. All of these are rounded ceiling. I mean, I can't even imagine the masonry work that goes into this. Just amazing. So this comes up to this position here.
is the original. These are fighting positions from atop. When you're coming in from the fork, you see the dark red on the outside. These are just offensive rifle ports. And this is interesting here because they can close down parts of this. And they have rifle port walls within the fort itself. This being one of them. So if people were to get in, they could retreat back to certain areas of the fort and still have access to firing outside. So this is the inside of the, immediately inside of the wall, there's a berm. So it's just amazing. The rifle port, different style. You come down another passage right here. This goes into another cannon or cannon room in here, where they have cannons aimed outside of the walls. And this one here is on a, they can actually pivot this to control the direction of the fire. Same port here, same port here, and another one here. This is an ammunition bunker. And here's LaLa admiring the engineering because there's no animals here. Look at the ceiling. Narrators here today, but we've been here multiple times. It's just one of my favorite forts to visit. So you'll notice it's very distinctive when you approach it from the outside. This fort is made out of two different colored bricks. It's a lighter red and a brighter red up on top. So I asked one of the curators here, one of the first times I came here, because it really is a prominent feature of this fort when you're walking up on it. So this lighter color brick came from Confederate states, and they were built. This fort was in the process of being built when it was taken over by the Union forces. Well, when the Union forces took it over, they began importing the brighter red brick from the northern states, shipping that clay down here, or shipping bricks down here that were manufactured up north. Which is why, and then they continued working on it. So the lighter color is clay and brick made from southern states, and the brighter red is clay made from the northern states. And again, there's just all kinds of passages throughout this entire fort that goes between the corners and
So this is the eastern side of the fort, looking out to sea. These gun mounts face out to sea, so any shipping or threats from the ocean will be taken care of by these guns. These guns are also rotate. I'd like to be on the gun crew moving these babies. Now, if you recall, when we were down in the magazines where they store the black powder, where they store the cannonballs, here's the hole where that ammunition would get passed up. So they would pull it up through these holes, load it into the cannons, and shoot it. This is the Nassau Sound that we're looking at right here. It's the border between Florida, where we're at, and Georgia. That, directly across the sound, is Cumberland Island National Seashore. That is a national park, only accessible by boat or ferry. On a non-busy day, what you'll see is wild horses that have been there for hundreds of years, walking along the seashore. Now, Cumberland Island National Seashore is in southern Georgia. Now, this would be the northern wall of the fort. So we've got three gun mounts on this side, and these guns are faced into the Nassau Sound. So here's the inside of the fort from cannon mounts. Straight out there, that relatively larger boat. It's going pretty slow. It's a shrimp boat, probably out of Fernandina Beach. Can't see where it's from. It's out there trolling for shrimp. And look at all these. We got 1, 2, 3, 8 gun mounts just facing. So that would be kind of the northwestern side of the fort. So you got 8 mounts or 9 mounts going down that side. That's just amazing. So anything that might land, any contingency of troops that may come in from that direction over that beachhead, is going to be met with that row of cannons. Really incredibly well preserved fort. I've been to a lot of forts, and this is one of my favorites.
is a drawbridge right here. So they could isolate the entryway to the fort.